Welcome, my name is Angelic Lavoy Torres. I'm a developer advocate here at Retool, and today we'll be learning about Retool Database. So I'll give you a walkthrough, you'll import some tables, we'll create some tables. So let's get started. So when we start out in our working space, we'll go to the navigational bar and click on Database. From there, it will open up a spreadsheet-like editor that is made on PostgreSQL. If we go over here in the sidebar, you will see all of your tables, and when you open them, it would actually have a tab at the top for quick access. Now, if we go to the left bottom corner, Retool DB automatically creates separate databases depending on which environment you're in. So you have development, staging, and production. And when you click on here, you have the dropdown that allows you to switch back and forth. Now in the center, you have the command center, and this has actions like import Google Sheets and also schema migration between the different environments that you have. And then it also has the typical filter search, and it even does like column visibility as well as sorting. Now let's dive in and create our first table. I'll show you two ways, the manual creation and the import CSV. First, let's create a table from scratch. So I'll go over here and I click on the sidebar new table, and there I can write my name of my table, so products. And from there, I can click on add column whenever I want to add something to the schema. I have first my ID, which is actually my primary key. Every table needs a unique identifier, and most of the time it's ID or whatever you assign it. It doesn't primarily have to be this. Just keep that in mind. Then I'm gonna do product name, and that's one as a text. Then I'm gonna do price, and I need that as a decimal, so number, integer, decimal. And then lastly, category, and that's fine as a text. And you can see different field types in here, right? You have text, number, dates, and boolean. And if you notice, you actually have foreign key. And the cool thing about this is that it allows to create relationships between tables with one another and connects them. But we'll talk about this in future videos. Now, unlike traditional spreadsheets, this database offers very powerful data validation features like data type, you also have the nullable, you also have the unique constraint, and the default value. So PostgreSQL's data type enforcement automatically validate entries, and it prevents users from entering letters when it's supposed to be just numbers, or for example, in the price field, or numbers in the product name. It also gives the ability for unique constraints that prevent duplicate entries where they shouldn't exist, such as ensuring that no two products have the same SKU code for when we're talking about products. And then you have nullable controls, which determines whether a field can be left empty. So for example, product name should not be empty because it should be a requirement, but a description can be empty. And yeah, so these features really create the guardrails for maintaining data quality and ensuring inventory systems remain reliable, unlike spreadsheets that you can go in and change them whenever you want, wherever you want, right? So now that I'm done here, I actually see the generate schema with AI, and I'll try it out. So I'll click create, have this create over here, and I'll click new table and go over. And what you do is actually give it a prompt. So I'm gonna do, I need a table for product info. And then enter, see what happens. Okay, and it created stuff like the product name, description, price, and even set up like what type it would be. And just like, I can go in and actually modify like, oh no, I don't think that would be a nullable. I need that to be true. Also, I think price should be, yeah, that's the most fine, and this should be unique. And yeah, I can click create. Oh, no table name can be left empty. My bad. I'm gonna do products V2 and click create. Now, let me show you a faster way, which is through importing CSV. So I'll go over here in the create new table, and I go into import from CSV, double click or drag and drop, and I have my expense data. I'm actually gonna link this down below for you guys to have access to it, or if not, you guys can bring your own data. So I'll click here, and we're now opening up this schema mapping interface. And it's basically asking the questions of, do the columns of my CSV match with what I want out of my database? And I can make any sort of corrections in here. I'm like the merchant, I'm like, maybe I want this to be an integer, or anything else. I'm like, oh, you know, this is a float, this is all fine. and then I can click over here. I have create a primary key or use a column. If I disable this, then it will create it for me. Otherwise, I would just use my ID. So create table. And then very fast. And the cool thing is that it's not that it has to be permanent, neither the primary key or the settings that you have. So I can actually go over here, go on settings, and then go, I don't want it to be a text. To be honest, I want this to be an enum. And this all seems good to me. So I'm going to save it. And then it's very easy, very fast to interact with. So thank you so much for watching. This is the end of our video. In this video, you were able to create, import, and also just get a general walkthrough of Retool DB. If you want to connect with other builders, I actually invite you to go to our community forum where you can talk to other people, get your questions answered, or just see in general what projects are being built. For the next video, we're going to be tackling on how to assemble your UI and how to best arrange components. So stick around and thank you.